This 5-micron requirement is essentially the hole size equivalent for an equivalent flow rate. And the way flow would, think of it, your typical garden hose or your pipe, you know, a certain size pipe will deliver a certain amount of flow at a certain pressure. And it's usually very consistent. As long as you run that, you know, that leak orifice at a set pressure, you're gonna get the same amount of flow through it. And so then when you do your leak test with that leak orifice becomes your leak standard. You're always gonna measure the same leak rate with that leak standard. Well, so 5-micron isn't a calibration. It's a measurement of the diameter of the optical. If you put it under a microscope, it's 1 × 10⁻⁶. That's what a micrometer is. So you take a meter, 1/1000th of that, 5 of them. Okay, so small, you can't see with your eye. It's microscopic. So you look at a microscope and then you measure it. We would ship with the what we call an LA04 leak orifice. The leak orifice is basically a quick connect on one end, and then there's a very tiny micro, usually 2, 3, 4, 5 micrometer or microns or micrometers or whatever you want to say. But basically, you know, 5 microns is usually what you want to detect for your typical leak rate. And then on the other end is usually like either a filter, or in this case, it's actually just open, which is fine because we're doing positive pressure testing. And this will usually get installed with a T adapter if you want to do inline fault detection. So you can essentially install a fault into your system and see that you can measure it. Yeah, so they manufacture it, yeah. So typically, that will be based on a set of criteria for pressure and leak rate, as in cc's per minute typically, and that translates into a micron hole size. Some people go the other way, they want a specific hole size, and then whatever that is at whatever pressure it is, whatever flow rate. What we would do is we would send that off to a certified lab to do that. If you're measuring something, and as long as it's not blocked, or you know, you treat your orifices well and you maintain them, you don't, you know, obviously dunk them in any, you know, contamination, you know, they're going to perform as they perform. There's nothing mechanical that's going to go wrong per se. Now, if it were plugged, if something happened and something got dropped on it, if it got really, you know, damaged and you were no longer reading, you know, leaks properly or really bad numbers, then you could say something is bad with your leak orifice. You would send it to a lab. They'd give you a measurement. They'd be like, oh yeah, this number is way down, or you know, it's almost reading zero. It looks like something got in there and stopped it up. It's blocked. That does happen from time to time. We provide filters on both sides. So if, again, I'm going to show you the leak orifice. There is a filter on one side and a filter on the other side. I believe we use either a 5 or 10 micron particulate filter. So that prevents, typically, it's a bronze filter, inline filter, that typically prevents, you know, any kind of contamination. As long as you are running it in a normal environment with clean air, you know, ISO standard clean air, with no oil in the line, you should have no problem keeping the orifice running perfectly fine for years.